Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Siege of Dragonspear, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Is the map working? Yay, map works again. Okay, well this is the special 100th episode, so extra huge episode. I'm going to start it off really exciting, moving sacks of grain around. Well, I've moved all the rest. I think we're supposed to move him to this barrel. He didn't specify.
Yes.
But I've moved all of them except for one. You can just go like that.
Keep watch for ancient tomes or any scrolls that might contain lost arcana.
Or sacks of grain.
Welcome. What can I do for you today?
I moved that grain for you. You moved every single sack over there? Left none behind? Great. Now I have another task for you. This part's a bit more complicated, so listen carefully. What you need to do is take all the grain you just moved and move it back here. Move it back. What? Wait, what? You asked for work. You didn't ask for important work. So move it all back here or be on your way. Now I'm supposed to move the grain back to where I found it. Ladle, a gnome at the Crusader Depot, now wants me to move the grain back to its original location. Now, he has the weight, but he doesn't have the slots, but I don't feel like moving all his stuff around. Can this... can't go up there. Can't go in the quiver, this stuff. So, I don't feel like moving his stuff... I mean, I could... but I don't feel like arranging at all. So I'm just going to cut this part off. I'm going to move forward time. And I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, the last four. I only got to make... well, with this will be four trips.
Keep watch for ancient tomes or any scrolls that might contain lost arcana.
You said that recently.
Welcome! What can I do for you today?
I moved that grain again for you. I have to admit, I didn't think you'd stick with it. I'm impressed. The problem with operations like this one is you got a lot of people standing around who are used to action. I don't need a pack of restless crusaders on my hands. You know the difference between work and useful work now, and you've proven that you can stick with the job. Here, take this. I have some questions. Okay, we got a potion of mind focusing and a potion of clarity. 12,000 experience. Wow. Just removing some crates. Nothing for that. Much luck to you. I finished moving all Ladle's crates. Moving the crates was Ladle's way of giving me busy work. He admitted such labor keeps Crusaders from getting antsy and fighting amongst themselves. It is sound management technique, I suppose, but a complete waste of my time. Mm-hmm. Mind focusing. Yeah, this helps when you want to mesmerize spells. And clarity prevents feeble mind confusion, fear, and charm. They're both pretty useful. We'll keep them in here for now. Okay. Are these the same? Wait a second. These are arrow plus two. Oh, these are one. Okay.
Aye.
Okay, so over here is a dragon. Spirit dragon. We have not explored over here. Can't go that way, it's a waterfall. Can't go in the water to see if there's any treasure behind it, of course. So, let's go up north first. So, since this is an extra long episode, I might just be finishing this underground river location in this episode. Unfortunately, we do not have any more charges available, and the in the, what do you call it, of the spectacles of spectacle. Otherwise, we could see what that is, what kind of demon that is, and converse with it, and possibly fight with it. These guys have potions. Oh. I had no idea we split up like that. Okay.
You want me? Hidden away.
In a manner of speaking.
Right.
Search ahead. Hopefully no traps. At least the patrol.
Hidden away.
So we got a gate or something here. Who's that? Strunk and water elementals. Seems like we could speak with him. He's trying to conjure something?
Yes.
Or converse with those water
hidden away
elementals. Still wants us to go west. People are joining us here. Enjoy your freedom while it lasts. Soon it will be mine. Soon you'll be mine. When this ritual is complete, you can wave goodbye to your freedom. So the water elemental has nothing to say to us. That's not that surprising.
Forgive me if I lack the time for conversation, fellow crusader. I'm in the middle of a delicate ritual.
I gather you're an arcanist of some sort. What manner of ritual is this?
I'm binding water elementals from this river. Creatures of pure water that will serve me as I do Kalar's work on the battlefield. With their power, the crusade's success is assured.
They will do your bidding? Willingly or unwillingly? Willing, unwilling, what does it matter? Better these creatures die than Kalar's worthy servants. Let me share my own view of the situation with you in the form of your horrific demise. The needs of the lady outweigh the needs of the few, okay? They are lesser creatures with nothing to offer but their strength. If I can bind them, why not use that strength for the greater good? This ends now. Or leave. Or what's this? Poke you. It's like a morality thing. Like, they don't mind. Like, they would mind being summoned and he would mind being poked. Like a same, like a similar thing. I guess. I don't want to just attack him outright, and I don't want to just leave. Either. If you can bind them, but can you do that if I were to poke you? What then? Eh? Does this bother you? Do you not like being poked? Do you want to die? You're endangering us both with this foolishness. Let me endanger you some more. My apologies. I was only jesting.
No. No, I don't think so. But this is a stroke of good fortune. I need to test my control over my minions. Elementals, attack!
Oh, boy. Okay. Well, let's see if we can evaporate the elementals.
You want sword first? What?
Oh, he's shielded.
What?
Yes. Trouble?
Yes.
Yeah, I've got some of these meteors left.
Yes.
Sweetheart?
Yeah?
Yes, Abel.
Aye.
Minsk and Viconia will take on the big one. And the rest of us will try to get rid of these two that are badly injured.
No mercy for those who oppose us!
Oh my.
I am yours to command.
What is it?
Oh, and Strunk is still here. Let's get rid of him.
Yes. What?
We can talk to this one? Spelling.
Yes, whatever you like.
By demand?
What?
I'm coming for you.
Char, take me.
Oh god, Viconia's out.
Huh?
And this guy's no longer talking.
What? Hey there.
Oh.
Such menial tasks.
I promise thee, thy debts shall not be in vain.
Oh, there's a Nereid? I'm saying that right? What have you done? Where is Rishthinsha? Good afternoon to you, Mistress. I assume Rishthinsha is one of the water elementals. Would that I had better news to give you on its fate. These waters, they ripple with violence and death. You have done this? It was this wizard's fault. He's the one who was trying to enslave your friends. I shall visit death upon you as you did for my friend Rishthinsha. Okay, we've killed the other one. Strunk dispel effects. One arrow of anti-magic. Target suffers a non-cumulative 50% chance of spellcasting failure for the next 5 rounds.
You want me?
Do it. Too bad we only have one left.
What is it?
Trouble?
Do it.
Aye.
Yeah, he's fine otherwise. He's just damaged. Okay. I want to raise her yet. Let's wait until we get rid of at least one other of these combatants here. Well, this one's near death.
friend.
Okay. The Nereid is attacking Sapphire. She saved us his death. Okay. That's ineffective. So let's try something a little better. Cone of cold.
Yes?
Actually, hold on. Oh, we don't have... Yeah, we used up mirror image.
I hear.
Oh, he just cast stone skill on himself. Well, he still took damage, and now we've got... Oh, now the Crusaders want to attack us.
When danger calls, means cancer. Sword first.
Sweetheart?
So we keep using the arrows and dispelling on him.
Trouble.
Yeah. I'd say that.
Take another champ.
I kick bad butts and I cannot. There is only one boo.
He's poisoned.
Except no substitutes.
Die cold.
What is it?
Oh, she's poisoned. Anyone else poisoned? Take this.
What?
Is she good now? Yeah.
Make way, evil! Hurry. I'm armed to the teeth and packing a hamster!
Still waiting for him to take this poison. Oh, he's blind. Can he take a potion if he's blind? Maybe not.
Yeah?
What do we have? Do we have that on you? Slow poison we have. Is that gonna be good enough?
Yes?
Yes?
Here. Have a heal.
Yes?
Don't you have something? Slow point. Wait. Where is she? She's back here. No one's been hitting her. Here, have her do slow poison. And you will do cure moderate. Nope! We won't do anything of the sort.
What?
So why do the-
Hear me! I shall.
Fall down now.
Yeah, this is no good. Now all these come. Why are all the Crusader patrols attacking? And what the hell is she turning into, a dragon or something? I mean, I can paralyze one of them. Not all of them. She's dead too.
Yes.
Wow.
Push me around. You might get pushed back.
Nope. Wow, why do they all attack?
Let's talk more fight!
Is it worth it? I mean...
Hidden away.
I would totally fight this battle. But if it's gonna make all the Crusaders hostile, I don't think it's worth it.
A den of stinking evil. Yes, yes.
I'll talk to them. To him.
Forgive me if I lack the time for conversation. I'm binding water elementals from this river. Creatures of pure water that will serve me as I do Kalar's work on the battlefield. With their power, the crusade's success is assured.
All right, so instead of poking him or telling him I'm going to end it, I'm going to say, thank you for telling me of your work. I must be gone on my own business now.
No. No, I don't think so. But this is a stroke of good fortune. I need to test my control over my minions. Elementals, attack!
Yes, dear.
He's still talking as the new game is loaded.
Yes.
All right, sorry, guys. I don't want all the Crusaders to be going against me. Can we not talk to him
Hidden
at all?
Away.
Is that what happens?
Forgive me if I lack the time for conversation, fellow Crusader. I'm... No. No, I don't think so. But this is a stroke of good fortune. I need to test my control over my minions. Elementals, attack!
No attack.
Aye.
Can we even...
Yes.
Can we even pass through here? That's another question. What if we try to pass through and do not speak to him?
Hidden away.
Alright, well, nothing happens. Angie says, get out of here. That's a tall tale if I ever heard one. All these Crusaders. And there's no way to defeat him. Before the Crusaders patrol comes by, because there's at least two patrols, as we've seen, and they come by rather frequently. Bardilla says, "A tall tale? Best not let the captain hear you talk like that. And look at the marks on the walls, if you don't believe me."
Hidden away.
Angie says, she's right. I saw it happen. Ferris dropped an entire vial of fire breath potion in the pot, stopper and all. A few seconds later, boosh. There's that word, boosh again.
Hidden away.
Angie?
You need something?
You again. Warm up by the fire, if you like. Did we meet them before? Spence says, ho, mercenary. Come, have a drink with us. And Bardilla says, God, Spence, I told you what happened the last time one of the sellswords joined us. Yeah, you told me, and I still don't believe it. Don't believe what? Angie says, you're going to love this. It was a mercenary named Ferris. You know him? No great loss if you don't. The oaf dropped a vial of fire breath potion in this pot. I can't decide what's more miraculous, but that didn't kill him, or that brass breaker also didn't kill him once things had calmed down and we'd clear the air. Clear the air? Bordilla says, breathe deep. You can still smell it, even now. What kind of creature is that? Spence says, now we have to keep all explosive potions sealed up in crates at the depot and hike back there if we need one. Bloody Ferris. I still can't believe anyone was that stupid. Huh. Well, I guess that's the crew. The patrol.
You need something? We serve the light. We serve the light.
Hidden away.
It's cold down here. Have yourself a drink.
May you know the happiness of a warm hearth and home.
But move on, mercenary. I've had enough trouble with your lot. Conflicting statements there. Okay. Well.
Yes?
Hidden away.
Oh. Once again, the stone dowser moves as though alive, straining on its chain, pulling its holder south. So we can cross here. Oh. An Ettin ghost? Can we rest around your fire?
Hidden away.
We're gonna get some spells situated here. An Ettin ghost is over there. All right, good.
You want boo? Let's talk more fight!
Thank you very much. If we kill the Ettin ghost, will these things come after us again? These patrol people?
You are right. Yes, yes.
Not you.
Done and done.
What? A simple matter.
I am yours to command.
I mean, that's not someone we can talk to, is it? Hold on.
Sweetheart?
I don't think it was.
Hidden away. Right.
Oh, he's attacking already. Never mind.
Yes, dear.
Yes?
Let's see if we can lure him right into a fireball. Did we hit one of these? I don't think we did. Oh, Sapphire took damage. We took damage? That was pretty far away.
All right. What?
Oh, it wants to talk now.
Sword first.
It wants to talk.
Smash!
Do you want me to smash you? Very well, if you insist. Ken, is there any chance you could talk some sense into this spirit?
Maybe, Ghost, open your eyes. See me. Talk with me.
You stab me with shiny bright bits. Eat your skulls, me will.
That's true. I am not the one who stabbed you. You died long ago.
Me? Dead?
As far as dead giants go, you're pretty lively. Your body is, but your spirit lingers on here. Have you any idea why?
In battle, me drop club. Good club. Made of leg bone. Came from Grandpop. Can't leave without club.
I'll look for your club. If I find it, I'll return it to you here. Agreed?
Me want club back.
I'll take that as a yes. The Lost. If I find the Ettin's club, I should bring it to his ghost. I came across an Ettin ghost who I believe lingers in the Prime Material Plane searching for a missing club. If I find it, he might be able to move on.
Yeah?
Well, Bol?
Hidden away. Hidden away.
Trouble? Sword first.
Alright. So where's this club? Ooh. The stone dowser spins on its chain, swaying neither left nor right. If Fosse dug deep, told it true, you are standing on unstable earth. The rocks below you feel solid enough, but the shadows of the cavern roof's stalactites suddenly have a previously unnoticed air of menace to them. Ooh. Okay. Not menace to us, just menace if we plant something here that can be... That would go boom. or boosh, whatever. Well, there he is. Can we talk to him more?
Smash!
No need to smash. I'm still looking for your club.
Me want club back.
Hidden away.
Well, you can help us look for it.
Aye.
We just found a place to go boosh. We haven't found your club yet. Is that you making that noise? Oops. Nothing in the cavern ceiling indicates any weakness you can detect, but if the stone dowser can be believed, placing the barrel of boosh here could have a devastating effect on the Crusade's dragon spear defenses. Let's keep the barrel for now at least. We can't walk down there. And this, the dragon's over here. Well, the ghost. The dragon ghost thing. We got a lot of ghosts of things going on here. I'm guessing that's him making that sound. Well. If I were in Ettin Club, where would I be? He might be back in that cave. It might be back in that cave. Maybe we couldn't find it before. Because there was an Ettin corpse there. Unless it's going to be up here more. I'm not going this way yet. Oh, his Turin Brass Breaker? Crusader Guards.
Halt! Identify yourself!
I come on urgent crusade business. See here? I have Kalar's crest. And a lovely little crest it is, but you still haven't identified yourself. My name is Sapphire. Oh yes, like that woman in Baldur's Gate? The one who fought, what's his name, of the Iron Throne? An unfortunate coincidence. Forgive me, my lady. Kalar herself bid me protect these doors from any who do not walk in light. May the lady's light shine on you always, ma'am. Oh! Okay, I can enter the caverns beneath Dragonspear Castle. I thought she was forbidding me once more just now. Oh. So. Oh, it's a done quest. It's a done deal. The Stone Dowser has found the spot I'm to place the Bowel of Bruche. Thanks to the Stone Dowser, I now know where to place the Bowel of Bruche to ensure the greatest impact upon Crusaders gathered in Dragonspear Castle. I've marked the spot on my map, lest I need to return. Alright. And then... the traitor. I can enter the caverns beneath Dragonspear Castle. Thanks to Kalar's crest, I was able to bluff my way past the guards without bloodshed. Once inside the belly of the beast, I should be extra careful not to provoke any unnecessary fights, lest the entire castle will converge in upon me. So Pritchard's done. That's why Glint won't talk to us. I mean, it still shows up as a quest to talk to Glint, but problem for Pritchard is done. Pritchard Gardnerson's son will no longer interfere with the effort to thwart Kalar. Timora smiles upon the forces besieging Dragonspear Castle. Any issues Pritchard's Gardnerson's continued involvement in the coalition against the Shining Lady could have been nipped in the bud. Right. Oh, this is the same. This is the same quest. The Ettin's Club and the Ghost's Remains. Now, people wanted stuff. Is this from... this is some from the Crusader camp. Signet ring. Battle standard. Oh, did I not pick that up? A holy symbol with rubies for eyes. Homemade tokens. A map of the Crusade's progress. I don't know where this is. Is that from just up above? Because I didn't find any of those things.
Yes?
Well, I'm not going in there yet. You keep the way open for us. I'll be back. I need to go find a club for an end ghost. Long story. I can't even talk to this guy without all the patrols going against me. And... I don't know if that's supposed to be that way. Might be very well be in there, but let me go check this over here. Not far from it. You can stop swinging. I know where to... you know what? We can take this off. put it away. Let's check what I think is his corpse. Oh, noisy.
Yes.
This was unsearchable before, I'm pretty sure. Oh, look at that. A club. Trying to see if even Minsk would be weighed down by it. It is. Oh, only weight 3. Ettin club plus 1. This club, fashioned out of a single giant leg bone, is as unwieldy as it is heavy. In a giant's hands, it would be a formidable weapon. Oh, I guess these are the stats for us, not the Ettin. Because if we try to use it, it would be minus 5 penalty to Thaco. 2d6 plus 1, which is pretty decent damage. Speed factor 9. It's slow. One-handed. Requires 18 strength. Oh, not 3. Its weight is 20. Where did I get 3 from? Maybe it said it was weight 3 until I identified it. Give it to Minsk.
You want Boo?
We got it. Got your club, big guy. Big ghosty guy.
Sword first.
So I wonder if it is worth it to kill this guy and then kill all the patrols. Because then they would... Wouldn't they be alerted to our presence? We wouldn't have any kind of surprise attack once we got inside the castle, right? Your watery might is no match in my arcane powers. He's still talking to them. Hello? Here, spirit. I found the club you lost.
Club is back. Now me scare scrawny humans.
Is this too hard for him to understand? Wait, I thought you wanted the club so you could move on to the afterlife.
Here, me give present to you. Take loincloth.
Cover yourself, my... Okay, yes, that was the only thing he had on. I don't really want your loincloth. Thank you, though. No, please. Please, just leave it on.
He didn't really need the club to scare scrawny humans.
I suppose not.
Me go now.
So it's not a done quest, because we still got... these guys. Now that the Ettin's ghost is at rest, I need to find the fugue plane where I can put these other remains. I returned the club to the Ettin's ghost. Unfortunately, he gave me a reward. Should I ever encounter a giant in need of help again, I'll establish a firm no nudity policy before agreeing to assist. Well, he actually didn't give us... There's a cloak here. Where is that? Oh, was that his loincloth there? I thought he put it back on. No, he just dropped it. I think. I mean, who would really want to wear this? Even if it does have magical properties like it does. Cloak of the Strange Beast. This thick pelt can be worn as a cloak by human-sized creatures or a loincloth by larger creatures. The beast that contributed its hide for this item is a mystery, but long slashes in skin indicated it was stabbed to death with sharp objects. Despite its enchanted nature, the hide still attracts fleas and retains the sweat and odors of its wearer. Armor class plus one, charisma minus one. It does bring us down to another Really? Who would benefit from this? I mean, his charisma's bad enough already. Safana has the highest charisma. Maybe when we buy expensive items, it should be her at the front of the party. I can't imagine Viconia wearing that. Maybe McKin. It would put McKin to charisma 11 and armor class minus 1. But what does McKin have for a cloak right now? Rallaire's mistake. Oh, polymorph into a wolf. Polywolf, which I, never used that. Oh, it's heavy too. Is it? Oh, it's weight 3. Mm. Alright. A little stinkier than before.
I love dungeons. They're usually bursting with gold.
What?
Alright, so we got a few things to do before we leave here. I'm guessing we're placing the barrel and then going right into the cavern? The castle, which is this way. Oh, to the Warrens.
Let's talk more fight!
Careful, you're getting my spellbook wet. Kind of strange we can't talk to him at all. So where does this go? So we have this to do. We have to go poison the evil tree over here, and then we have to get past the ghost dragon over here before we go up here. So we've got three things to do, so
your need. Hidden away whatever you like.
If she opens a door, I think she comes out of shadows, right? Whoa! What the hell?
Hold your attacks! Fall back!
Whoa! Whoever said that was thoroughly some kind of battle or explosion.
Stand your ground. Rein the driders in.
Oh yeah, there's driders. And these must be drow. And we've got hobgoblins. Or are these bugbears? Shapur said that.
This assault benefits neither of us. I suggest a parley.
I suggest you withdraw.
What's going on here? Why are you fighting? Thurley says, these drow attacked us without provocation. We were defending ourselves.
We did not come here to fight. Wait. Who is that at your side? Viconia? Viconia de Vere? Can it truly be you?
Cool. Maybe we'll have an ally on our side. We can talk these guys down.
Shapur, it's been a long time.
You two know each other? It has been a long time, but not long enough for my taste. Viconia of House de Vere, it sickens me to look upon you. Okay, well there goes that idea. Oh god, this is cold, this second one. But this is like something... This is something Viconia would say if she was, well, me. Or if I was her. But I'm not her. I'm me. So, ho, mind your tone. Viconia is a friend of mine. I'll not let you speak ill of her in my presence. It's more of a Minsk thing to say, right?
Please, you'll only make things worse.
Worse? How is that even possible? Your actions are unforgivable, Devere, beyond any justification. You turned your back on the Spider Queen. That is true. If I ever met someone called the Spider Queen, I sure wouldn't turn my back on her. I defer to your wisdom in this matter, Viconia.
You did not come here to argue theology, Shapur. Tell us why you have ventured this far up from the Underdark.
That is awesome. Very well. I will pretend you are nothing more than a dung-covered rat fawning at this traveler's heels. Charming. Pray continue.
Two young drow, little more than adolescents, are lost in these tunnels. Bring them back unharmed, and I will spare your life.
I think I already met them. They were headed to the surface. I will find them. Did I really meet them? I don't think it'd be very easy to bargain with these drow. I've already met them. Two. Are those the two? Oh, is that why they were such jerks? If it's those two down south in the cavern, not far from the ghost dragon, kind of between the ghost, the dragon ghost, and the Poison Crusaders. We rescued two people. I figured they were just adventurers. From an Ettin. And the female was very ungrateful. And the male, not so rude, but just couldn't believe we'd help them without wanting something in return. So that might be why I'm saying I have the option to say I think I already met them. But being drow headed to the surface is odd. Although Viconia spent plenty of time on the surface, so it's not unheard of. In any case, maybe it's someone else, I've forgotten. So in any case, I think I already met them. They were headed to the surface. Wait! Quickly! Zahan's eye! After them! Okay. Cannot save at this time, okay.
Trouble? Let's talk more fight!
You helped us out of a tight spot, and no mistake. Those drow would have killed us to a soldier. Here, it's not much, but I hope you'll accept this cloak and thanks. I appreciate it. Time to head back to the surface. We've gained a cloak. And a healing potion. Maybe it's something better than an Ettin loincloth? Cloak of the Gargoyle. Though this dark gray cloak appears to be made of stone, it is soft and flexible as cloth. When donned, it allows its wearer to assume a statue-like form once per day. These cloaks are often found among the Dwargar, who first designed them, but occasionally one winds up on the surface. Alright, so physical damage resistance, plus 5%, and protect against critical hits. Stone form once per day. Okay, then these are the stats for stone form. Armor class 0, plus 3 saving throws, minus 3 dexterity, lasts for 5 turns. That's interesting. I think we all have a cloak at this point. This helps reverse missile attacks, which happens. armor class plus 2. Plus 1 caster level. Yeah. Ettin cloak. Loincloth. Immunity to slow and cold resistance. See, the only thing is I always forget to use charged items. Especially things like cloaks. Well, let's give it to her. Because how often does cold resistance come into play and slow? So... it doesn't...
Okay. Aye.
A dim purple glow from deep within this yawning chasm illuminates the cavern wall. Howling winds and distant footsteps can be heard far below. Indeed.
Yes, whatever you like.
Is that an illusion? So where did they run off to? There's nowhere to go in here.
I swim in memories of places such as this. Most unpleasant memories.
Well, that was interesting. The back and forth between Devere, Vaconia Devere, and her.
Yes?
Minsk agrees. Drop point for Barrel of Bruch. Yeah, that's the entrance way to something. No question, though. If I cross over here, no, I can't get down there. I can't step in this water at all. Just awfully limiting.
Sword first!
I wish I could fight that guy without the Crusaders. Well, that's the cave. Never mind. So you have to go all the way around. I don't think any of these monsters would come back. Whoa! Did we not fight these, or did they come back? Shriekers? and ride my conid. All right.
You want Boo?
By demand?
Yes.
I still have these things again.
Fear mainly for those who oppose us.
Shake her down. Two red myconids.
What?
I said it was two and? Red myconids. Oh.
Hey there.
What is she using? Okay, she's using back to arrow plus one. Okay.
What is it?
It's dead! It's dead!
Bleed for Shah!
That stings, doesn't it, evil?
Huh? Yeah? I'd say that stunk. Stung. Probably stinks too. Safana attacks Dinah here. Well, that's wonderful.
I hear. Whatever thy wills, like done and done.
She's only using arrows plus one.
What?
So we are what? With her. She's confused.
What?
This. Move sphere and charm, feeble mind, so that. Confusion.
Bell's gone.
Ah. Attacking McKinn.
Do it. All right. Trouble.
Well, luckily she has a lot of tries to get it done. This one, right? You're back. Okay, good. Stop attacking our teammates.
Trouble? Yes.
Hurry.
Speak.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, so a point go up, she has regenerating cloak.
Yeah?
Sweetheart? Whatever you like.
Any traps around here? Spores or anything like that? A dwarven.
Keep watch for ancient tomes or any scrolls that might contain lost arcana.
Shush. A dwarven warrior hewn from solid stone stands eternally watchful, guarding the massive doors beyond him. A dwarven warrior. Alright, well, we don't want her going in there by herself.
Aye. Sword first.
Now I think this thing's a reluctant thing. You try my patience, little elf. Begone. So this one, we can't look at these.
Go no further.
Be gone, elf. None shall pass through here. All that try shall die.
Yes, sword first.
Good. I am glad you were courageous enough to pass me by.
You want me to go through?
I did as I was bid. But I'll do no more than that. Your passage will displease my master, which pleases me greatly.
Huh.
Fare thee well and lost Kanaglym.
Okay. Well, the dragon would not refuse to tell us who the master is, so I'm not going to ask again. If we get one more question, what exactly is a Kanaglym? A farewell wherever I go. What exactly is a Kanaglym and why am I going into it? I can say its name, but nothing more. Now go, before your presence is discovered. Ghost Dragon Guardian. I should pass by the dragon into the room beyond and try to find whoever controls it. A ghost dragon stands guard over the entrance to a place called Kanaglym. It attempted to frighten me off, but was unwilling to take direct action against me. It is bound by some external power, forced to act in a manner not its choosing. Perhaps I can free it from this bondage. Well, so even though it's gone, it's still in... It has bondage.
You want Boo?
It's still in bondage. Okay. That looks like a similar place to put the barrel of Boosh.
Yes, dear. Hidden away.
Oh. Oh no, this is the place to put the barrel of Boosh. Never mind.
What? Yes.
Never mind, Minsk. I know what I was talking about. We can't walk over here. Oh, we can.
Hidden away.
So I think over here is where I found those drow. So they were going up to the surface. Which doesn't often happen.
Hidden away.
Well, we're right here. I might as well go in. In this case, we die horribly because I know I saved, but I did unravel more of the map. This is what we saw on the other side that I couldn't figure out. Interesting. Years of accumulated rust have transformed this door into a wall. It will not open for you or anyone else. This sturdy, well-crafted door resists all efforts to open it. Interesting. The remnants of an old dwarven fortress.
Your need?
Shadows. Hiding in shadows is failing. Maybe we can't hear for some reason?
Hidden away.
Oh, here we go.
Right.
Whoop! Oh, we're slowed. Any more traps? An unearthly light glows from deep within the chasm. Voices echo throughout the gaping crevasse. Crevice? Pressing against the walls, seeking escape. Another door resists attempts. I'd rather wait until this slow effect wears off. Because it involves just standing around, though. The door's dwarven craftspeople made certain none but the one who held its key would ever be able to open it. Peering through a crack, the light that leaks inward reveals nothing of interest or value. Alright, I think our slow is worn off. Yes. She's holding on to Minsk's ring of free action. Oh, it's not a ring of free action, it's Edvintara's gift. It's immune to haste and slow, yeah. But the rest of us aren't slowed anymore, so that's good.
Yes. Hidden away. Whatever you like.
I don't know what's in here. I have a bad feeling about it. Same thing. Be hit by a trap, but I don't want monsters coming after her either. Speaking of which, here's a tattered skeleton.
Hey there.
Hey there, big boy.
Right.
My magic will end thee!
Get up!
Hells, I missed!
Here comes 300 pounds of justice!
Skeleton archers.
Demand? What?
Sweetheart?
Hmm? Yeah, so we're both attacking this one, right?
Yes, I am.
There's a lot of archers, and I don't like that.
Yes?
A shadowed soul. Oh boy.
Yes?
What?
Nice, I don't think any of us took damage from that fireball. So since we're staying here, let's do it again.
And I hear thy called.
Oh, we're out?
What is it?
Yeah. Throw one over here as well.
Yes.
You want boots?
Do it.
Let's throw in some more heals here. Shadowed Soul is down.
What?
Taking us a while to get. Take down the skeleton warrior.
I am yours to command.
Well, Well, the bladed skeleton's attacking Vaconia, so she's not being able to get a spell off.
What? Huh?
That's good.
Trouble.
Well, keep that up.
Trouble?
Thy demand?
Aye.
Yes?
This guy's tough, huh?
When danger calls, means answers.
It's because he's using swords. Wait a second, doesn't he have something that's... I mean, this is really good against undead. And then he has this. I don't remember if we had something else that was good against undead. That's against lycanthropes. Yeah, I guess that's it, really. Though we had another undead sword.
I kick bad butts and I cannot lie!
Hurry!
Last moderate.
I need healing to fight on.
Alright. Switch it to that one.
There's only one move.
Oh.
Except no
substitutes. Oh, don't switch you. No. You don't need that. I was on someone else. Alright, we're out of moderate. Took
make
it.
Way, evil! I'm armed to the teeth and packing.
Thy wish for
hamster.
Intelligent conversation?
No. I want you to kill this thing.
What is it?
Go for the ice, Boo! Go for the ice!
Alright, we killed that. Now we've got bladed skeleton, armored skeleton, which is badly injured.
Aye.
This takes a long time to cast, unfortunately. How about a little faster?
Push me around. You might get pushed back.
Here. Heal him. That's what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
You are hitting him with this. Divine Wand of the Heavens, which casts Flame Strike.
What?
Get that meteors going.
He pestereth me with more demands.
Melf's Acid Arrow. Too bad you had good undead. Arrows. Good for versus undead.
Yes.
Alright, we killed that one.
Jalbir and Pulse. You're near. Wouldst thou like to see a magic trick? There! I has thy nose. Thine asks... what do you want?
Haste.
Yes.
Try to get on in his haste here.
You want Boo? Here comes 300 pounds of justice!
Grub Doubler, here.
Char guides my hand.
Repeat.
Thy called. Done and done.
That stings, yes? Doesn't it, Evo?
Ouch.
What?
That ouch.
Trouble?
I'm doing everything you ask. Don't push me.
Keep doing it.
I believe it's almost time for a new hairstyle.
Okay, good.
I hate all of you. Deeply.
Aye. Yes.
Bring it on home, guys. Wow. Fire opal ring, and that's all we want from these guys. And then what did this say? Same thing. Wow. Pretty crazy.
Yes, Abil. I swim in memories
so,
of places
all goblins
such
look
as
alike
this.
To you.
Oh god.
That's what you're saying?
Unpleasant
racist
memories.
Yep.
I don't know where that comment comes from. That should not happen because you click on a character. Doesn't make any sense. Maybe it's supposed to be funny? I don't know. I do not find it to be such.
Hey there. Yes, dear.
Maybe look for traps. Good thing you looked for it. More of that stuff.
What's this?
Fragments of the Dwarven community that once lived here. Not all dwarf. There's things here I can use. Those are goblin shaman robes. That staff, too. Or that armor. Couldn't do the summoning dance in it, but if it's as strong as it looks, it might keep me alive. Talking armor? Talking armor? That's new.
It happens. Talk, ghost. Who are you?
I am Crunter, Claw Lord of the Daft Decanter Clan.
He sounds like Gilbert Gottfried. Is that true? Are you sure? You don't look like the Lord of the Dak Decanter Clan. You look like a suit of armor.
You mock me?
Elf?
Forget them. Talk to me. How is it you're here, Crunter Dak Decanter?
I died, but I'm not leaving my armor. Oh no, it's mine, mine, no one else's.
See, now I've pretty much got to give your armor to my friend here.
What? You would foul my armor with this female? Never! I won't allow it!
Can you stop it?
bones to powder. Drink your blood like wine. I'll suck her soul out of her body and cast it down in the bone lands forever.
That's pretty extreme.
That means no.
I don't think I've ever... I might have tried the dance once, and it might have been off screen. Not recorded. I guess the armor is good, which we keep saying it's better. Well, I haven't had a chance to really look at its stats. Yeah, either one of these two. The decision is yours, McKin. This armor is superior to yours, but the cost is high. You'd exchange your dance's gifts for Crunter's company.
What world is mine? Flesh or ghost? Can't live in both, not anymore. Gotta pick. Shaman or warrior? Robes or armor? Don't know.
A shaman, okay. I've heard it pronounced both ways, shaman and shaman. Oh, we have a choice? Between taking robes and staff or the armor? Can I just loot the whole thing and bring it all with me? I'll let McKin decide. You are many things, McKin, but indecisive is not one of them. I mean, if they're forcing into a choice, I don't use the dance. I'd rather McKin have a higher armor class. I mean, I did give her a stinky loincloth of a dead Ettin to use as a cloak. We'll have an eternity in the spirit realm soon enough. Take the armor, McKin. Become a warrior. Well, that she could still use the shaman stuff. You know what? I'm not even sure. Okay. Yeah, we choose this.
You're right. I will do as you say.
McKin has found some treasure she can use. In a subterranean dwarf town, we found a set of goblin armor possessed by its former owner, Crunter. I convinced McKin to don the armor. She'll need it to survive in this world. Does she already have the armor on? This still has Jeg's leathers. This is the old armor. Who has the new stuff? Or nobody yet, I guess. Arrow plus one. What's happening? Arrow plus three here.
You want me? Yes, dear.
Throwing axe, robe, quarterstaff, and hide armor. So we can take all of them.
You want? Yes.
Well, this stuff might be heavy. Identify. The Soul Herder's Staff plus two. A gnarled wooden staff cut from the Dak Decanter Goblin Tribe's sacred tree. This item was a symbol of spiritual power for centuries. It disappeared during a hard-fought battle between the Dak Decanters and a dwarven clan whose name is lost to history, and those few who remembered it once existed thought it lost forever. It was found discarded in the lost dwarven town of Kanaglym, among other treasures the dwarves stole from their goblin enemies over the years. Alright, so it's a staff, and when you equip it, you have plus 15 magic resistance, 15%. Summoned spirits gain a plus 1 to strength, so I guess that would be the nymph. And whatever else. Backo plus 2, 1d6 plus 2, damage. Only usable by Mackin. Let's see what this is. Axe of Crunter, plus 2. As mighty a weapon as a goblin could hope to wield, the Axe of Crunter belonged to a decanter goblin warlord a century or more ago. Though a famous figure in his tribe, Crunter was less well known beyond it. After his death, his signature weapon moved from hand to hand in rapid succession, finally ending up discarded in the ruins of the dwarven town of Kanaglym. One extra attack per round. 33% chance per hit that the target takes 1 point of poison damage per second for 2 rounds. Save versus death, negates, returns to the wielder's hand when thrown. So it's another throwing axe like the one McKinn's already using. 1d6 plus 3, Thaco plus 2. If thrown, it's a missile, otherwise slashing. Alright. Alright, so this 1d6 plus 3. Same. That go plus 2. Okay. So the difference here is instead of the critical hit thing, which doesn't happen very often, or chance to score a critical hit, plus 5%, and then, oh yeah, plus 5 Thaco for 3 rounds. This one has the poison damage and 1 extra attack per round. This isn't much. 1 point of damage. Oh, poison damage per second for 2 rounds. A round is like 10 seconds, I think, right? Alright. Yeah, so otherwise, the plain damage is the same. But it has those extra abilities. So I'll take that and put that away. So then we've got these things. Here's a ring. So it's the fire opal ring. The Ghost Dreamer's robe. Seemingly little more than rags stitched together, the Ghost Dreamer's robe is actually an artifact of great historical significance that attacked the Cantor Goblin tribe. Each of the robe's dozens of patches were cut from the robe of an enemy tribe shaman. This makes the Ghost Dreamer's robe more than an article of clothing. It is a physical representation of the Dak Decanter's victories over the centuries and a symbol of power for the shaman who wears it. Armor class 5 improves casting speed by 1 and vocalize. Vocalize is good. It means you can't be silenced, I think. And, is that what it means? I think you can't be silenced, and you can cast spells without having to gesture. That's the effect that Dinah here has on with her thing. With her, one of her items. Yeah, what I'd give for a actual alphabetical listing of spells here. So not a priest spell, I wouldn't think so. It doesn't show up here. They don't have all the spells here either. Oh, here's vocalize, okay. Can cast spells with a verbal component without having to make any noise. Oh, that's what it is. This spell is Of great use when magic is quiet as a Zyder in spellcasting, or the individual has been magically silenced. So you cannot silence. Yeah, so you're taking out... You just make gestures. I had it the opposite way. So that's interesting, but armor class will go way down. Oh, I can't. McKin has chosen the path of the warrior and cannot equip the robes. Huh. Can't change back? What the hell, man? Hide armor, not identified. Hmm. Don't we have an identify scroll in here? It's too bad it doesn't recognize it when it's not in the pack. Or when it is in the pack. Crunter's armor plus 3. Once worn by the Decanter Goblin Warlord Crunter, this armor is of an unusually high quality, considering the race of its owner. Most non-goblin smiths won't bother making armor suitable for goblinoid physiques, while those few goblins who know how to use a forge are generally more focused on weaponry. Crunter prized this armor to such a degree that, upon his death, he refused to leave it. To this day, more than 100 years later, his spirit still permeates the armor, whispering threats to all who dare wear it, and generally making a nuisance of himself. He cannot directly harm the wearer, however, and for a goblinoid, the chance to have such fine protection might well make up for the aggravation the armor brings with it. Wisdom minus 1. Oh. I don't like that. And look at all this stuff. Open locks, minus all this stuff, 10%. Find traps, 10%. Pickpockets, move silently. I mean, I don't... I guess it's fine, because I don't use her as a thief. Immunity to stun is nice, though. Armor class 3, 5 versus piercing and missile. It's heavy, though. That's pretty friggin' heavy. Armor class now is negative 3. Overweighed with the armor. Because this thing's heavy. I mean, does it really? Is it minus 1? McKin's not letting that go, not without getting something in exchange. Okay. Ugh. Charisma 11. Because of the thing. So wisdom went down. Wisdom goes down to 16. Just curious about the, combat skills, abilities. Where do we see? Oh, we can change the voice sounds. Well, kind of curious where we see this stuff. The thieving skills. Just detect illusion, 64. You know, wisdom's down to 16 as well. But really good armor class. Now can still use spells though, right? Mm-hmm. Otherwise, yeah, deals off. Okay. We can use spells.
What?
Do I have any moderate left? Or medium, rather? No. Okay.
This group shows promise. Extraordinary.
I'm worried that we won't be able to cast this stuff, so... Yeah. Alright, yes, I can still do that. The only thing is that the shamanic dance is gone.
Do you seek to see me imprisoned or killed?
What?
Keep our profiles more discreet,
like,
then.
It's like, what? Alright, let's...
Huh? Let's talk more fight!
McCain is encumbered. Alright, I was gonna give this back. Back out here and rest. Dark Magician says, she may be a fool, but she's not stupid. She's beginning to suspect, I can tell. Another Dark Magician says, it's not stupidity that will lay her low, it's arrogance. She blinds herself to the truth. Wait, something's not right here. All hail Kaelor, Lady of Light. Well, I must admit, those are words I never thought I'd hear spoken in this place. Who are you? Bell's Claws, it's Sapphire. The Baal Spawn has found us out. Dragon, come to our defense. Halotathlir says, I am not compelled to honor your wishes. I was ordered to guard the door, nothing else. Defend yourselves, brothers. The Cabal. Can we just run back and... I have to defeat the Dark Magicians. Destroying these Dark Magicians will surely weaken the Crusade. What if we just run back in?
Trouble? Yes.
Trouble? Yes. The Lord of Murder's heir must be ours, Carrion says. Oh, the Nymph is still with us here. Well, evidently they do not wish to enter Kanaglym for whatever reason. So maybe we can rest here? That's what I was intending on doing anyway. Alright, so next episode, guys, we'll defeat these magicians. And we're going to explore the rest of this Kanaglym because there's more to see here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always seek adventure.